So guys, welcome to Learning Maths with Pulatsi YouTube channel. Now the last, I upload the grade 7 part 1 and part 2 papers. I think they have lovely comments for that videos. Lovely comments for that grade 7 Western Province first term 2018 paper. Thank you for all that lovely comments in that video. Now, today, title Grade 8 Department of Education Western Province First Term 2018 Paper Part 1 Part 1 that I do in this video. So let's see what the Part 1. Now there are 20 questions, you know. Grade 8 guys, let's we move to the questions. Now the first question, write the 7 multiply of 5. 7 multiply of 5. Now, what is the 7 multiply of 5? Now, if you get the term 5, separately we want to get this. 7 multiply. Multiply 7. Now that is the theory of this. Now term multiply from multiply. That. Now this 5 multiply 7, what is the answer? 35. Now that is the answer for the first question. Now you want to get the pass. Now this is term. You know this is multiply. Now that is the term. The term you want to what? Multiplication from multiply. Now that is the fine multiply of something. You want to keep it mind. Now the first lesson number patterns also you have this. The multiply something. And they have general terms also. You know that the first lesson. And the second question, simplify. Now, minus 6, subtract positive 3, the plus 3. Now, you know, they are the minus is the biggest one. The minus 1 have the subtract also. Now, that is the biggest one. So, that answer is minus 1. Now, we get minus 6 and plus 3 means... minus 3 because the biggest one is minus. How I get the answer? You want the thinking mind or you want to get the thinking mind method for the direct number lines. You get the 0 point and goes to negative 6 and there are positive 3 plus 3 and again plus 3. Now you get this is 0. And you continue to the minus 6. Right? Now they are at 3. Now you at 3 there and that is negative 3. So that is called the direct number lines thinking method. So you want to get that thinking method like that. So to simplify that like this. Third one, write the additive inverse of following numbers. Now there are two parts, negative 2, 1 over 3. Now you want to get the additive inverse of this. Let's we check that. You know the this method. Minus 1 means plus 1. So let's we check that. So they are negative 2. What? Plus 2 we want to get as the answer. Additive inverse means the directed number lines also there. Now negative 2. This is the negative 2. Additive inverse. You want to get an additive like. You want to get that in additive. Like that. So like that. Now this is positive 1. Now additive inverse means the negative to positive, positive to negative. Now additive inverse in the number lines, you can also get negative 2 plus 2, and they are compatible in the 4. Now like that. So, and this positive 1 over 3 means negative 1 over 3. Now you can get this. Now the negative means positive, positive means negative. Now that is the additive inverse. If you get this, 0 means, is 0 is positive or negative? No. 0, they are not having a positive or negative. So, answer is 0. Same. Like that. The fourth lesson also, they have an additive inverse in this. Okay, great day guys. Let's move to the next question in this paper. Part 1. This is a 4th and 5th questions in this paper. Great day guys. The 4th question, you look at table they have. Complete the table. Now you have a supplementary angles and complementary angles. Now, supplementary angles, their sum is 180. You know that supplementary angles. Complementary angles, they have 90 degrees sum. Now, A, B are complementary angles. Now, A means 60. Now, what is B? And A, B are supplementary angles. Now, B is 120 degrees. What is A? Let's recheck that. Now, you want to firstly, now A is 60. Now you want to find the sum of B. Now we get 90 degrees in here and A is 60. Now what we want to do? Now these two sums are 90 but the only A is 60. Now you want to find the B. Now we want to subtract this. Now you have an answer now. 30. Now you want to write this in here. 30 degrees. Now that is the answer for that. First one. The A is 60. B is 30. Altogether 90 degrees. That is complement. And the next. Supplementary angles. Now you have 120 degrees and 180 degrees and 120 degrees. This is B. Right? Now, you want to find A. Now, you want to subtract this. Now, you have answer 60 degrees. Now, you want to write in here. 60 degrees. Now, you want to firstly find the complementary angles. Supplementary angles, what the sum of that, degree, sum of that. And nextly, you want to subtract the sum 1 and get the answer and write in the sum banks or sum questions. In the 5th question, grade 8, underline the ones which are not platonic solids. You know the platonic means the one by one the same solid. Or you get the cube I draw it here. Now cube like this. Now they are all sides are what? All sides are equal. Now you get cuboid. Now I'll write cuboid like this. And regular tetrahedron. Regular tetrahedron means triangles, tetrahedron. ना किरणी? Like this regular octahedron, I think that is like this regular octahedron, square pyramid, regular octahedron, cuboid and cube. So some people say the tetrahedron, dodecahedron. So some people that say that. Now we want to underline the ones which are not platonic. Now let's check. You know the cube, they are all what? Sides are equal. All sides are equal. They have six faces. All six faces are square. Now you, cube is a platonic solid. Cube is a platonic solid. Cuboid? What is cuboid? Now you get the cuboid. This is cuboid. Now there are also six faces. Now four faces are rectangle, two faces are square. Now that is not a platonic solid. Now 4, 1, 2 and opposite side also 3, 4 and 5. They are also 6. Now 2 squares, 4 rectangles, so that is not platonic solids. Regular tetrahedron means, now you get regular tetrahedron like this. Now they have 1, 2, 3 and 4 faces. Now all faces are equilateral triangle. Or means the all are equilateral triangle shapes. Now that is a platonic solid. You get square pyramid. You get square pyramid. You look the square pyramid, they have 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 faces and the square one is all and 5. Square one also they have 5. Now, the square pyramid is 4. What? Isosceles triangles and 1 square. Now that is a not platonic solid. It is not platonic solid. Now you look there. 4 isosceles triangle and 1 square they have. So they have 2 different shapes. So that is not a platonic solid. Regular octahedron. Octahedron means like a diamond. Like a diamond. So all what? All faces are equilateral triangles, so that is a platonic solid. Dodecahedron, also like that. So this is your fourth question and fifth question. So guys, let's move to the next question in this paper part 1. Question, grade 8, guys, 6th and 7th one. 6th one, write down 2 digits that should not be in the ones place of perfect square number. Perfect square number. The square number means that the include from square number pattern. Write down 2 digits that should not be in the ones place. Ones place. Ones place. Now you get 14. The ones place, this is 4. 4 is the ones place, like that. So you get the square number pattern like 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, like that. So let's we get the ones place there. They are 1. They are 4. You know these 2. And they are 6. The 16, this is ones place. 25, this is the ones place. 5. 36, this is the ones place. 6. 49, this is the ones place. 9. Like that. So the 64, this is the ones less and 81, this is the ones less. So you observe clearly this, the 1496 56941. So the same time you continue and from the 1496 1496, the 5 will like that. Then I get the 1 to 9 square of values. Now they observe clearly 1, 4, 9, 6 and 5 only. I think they also have the 0 also. I think now they are, you look, they are no way out 2, 3, 7, 8. That are the digits that not be in the ones place in the square number. You look, observe clearly, they are now have 2. You want to write only 2 digits. And I write 7. You can write 3, 8 also. Again, you firstly get, you want to get the answer like this. You want to firstly write the square number pattern and you want to find the ones places. You want to classify like this, ones places, and continue this. There is, there I have 2, 3, 7, 8, like that. So these are the ones places of 2 digit numbers in the square number into 1 to 9. Now my choice is 2, 7. You can write 3, 8, 2, 8, 7, 8, like that. So you want to write only 2 digits to not be in the ones place. So this is the answer. Like that. So that the perfect square number, ones place digits. In the 7th one, find x. Now, they have an angle that find, you want to find this x. Now, this angle is 140 degrees, this angle is 150 degrees. Now, this is x. Now, you firstly, you look, they have a circle. Right? They have a circle. Now, you know, this is 360. Now, firstly, x plus 140 degrees plus 150. The all characters in this angle or the magnitudes, you want to classify like this. Adding, and answer is 360. If you have a straight line and like this, that is 180. Now you have like this. So you observe clearly they have a circle. Now that is the 360. The circle is 360 around the point. In the vertex is 360 degrees. Now x is 360. We want to subtract the sum 1. You look the 140 degrees and 150 degrees all together and you have answer 290. Now you want to subtract this from 360. Now, 360 subtract from 290 is what? 70. Now, this is the answer for 7th question. Find x. You want to firstly, this is what? What is this? Is a circle or straight edge? And get characteristics like this separately and get the sum. You want to sum, subtract, or the these all characteristics, all sums subtract from the full sum. And now you have a answer. Now the unknown term is this. This is 70 degrees. This angle is 70 degrees. Let's see, move to the next questions. Grade 8, guys, in this paper part 1. This is your next question in this paper, part 1. Now, grade 8 students, 8th question, simplify. Now, you have plus 2, multiply plus 6 and divide from minus 3. If you get this as the plus plus means plus. Now, you know that plus 2 means plus. Plus 6 plus plus 2 means plus 8, like that. So you can get this is multiply, so you can get as this, like this. 6 multiply 2 is 12. Now plus plus means plus. You get a number line, this is 0 and goes to plus 2. And again plus 6, you get there. Like that. So that is multiply. Like that. And you want to divide this from what? Minus 3. I divide from minus 3. Now you have an answer. You have an answer now. Right? Now you have an answer. What is the answer? So, the minus 1 is the biggest one. Divide also. And you know that 12 divided from 3 is 4. Now, the minus 1 is because, so you can write as this. You compatible again repeated. The plus 2 multiply plus 6 means. Now you get a number line 0 to plus 2 point. And again plus 6. Again plus 6. Right? Not negative 6. Again plus 6. Now that is 8. So this is multiplication one. So plus 2 multiply plus 6 also same. Plus 12. 6 multiply 2 is 12 plus same. And they are divide done and what? Minus 3. Minus 3 means the negative form. So you get the 12 negative form. You want to divide this. Now, divide from 3. Now you in the then now you in plus 12 point. And you want to divide from 3. You goes to 3. 3, 3. Correct? 3, 3, 3. They are divided from 3. You want to point 3, 3, 3. Like that. So, you have a minus 4. Because the divides mean the negative same. You want to get the minus is the biggest one. So, minus, you want to get now minus 4. Minus 1 is the answer. Ninth one, simplify this. 3 and brackets there I have x. Subtract y plus 5. Brackets close plus 2x. I think that is very difficult. Let's switch it. Now, you want to multiply this one by one. Right? You want to multiply this one by one. And now you have answer grade 8 guys. 3x subtract 3y plus 15 plus 2x. Right? Plus 2x. Plus 2x. Now 3y in there. 3x. I think the background sounds are very bad. Sorry for that. Sorry. Now you have an answer like this. Right? Now, what we want to do? You want to this one and this one and. Right? Is it correct? No. Is it correct? No. Yes. Now, 5x. 2x plus 3x mean 5x. Now, you want to subtract 1 and then 15 plus 3y. 15 plus 3 means 18. So, 18y. So, that is the answer for that simplify. You want to firstly get these all together. Right? And we want to firstly these two multiply and like this 3x, 3y 3 × 5 = 50 plus 2x. Now you want to first see that 3x and 2x are x1. So you want to add this and 5x. And now this is subtract 1. You want to subtract this. And now there are 15 plus 3y, they are remain. Now you want to add this. Now 18y is the answer for 9th one. So that is the method for find the answer like that. In the 10th question, write the number pattern n brackets n plus 1 brackets divide from 2. If you get the example like n is 10. Right? Now n is 10. Now you want to classify this pattern. Now n and n is 10 plus 1. And there I have divide from 2. Divide from 2 they have. N plus 1 divide from 2 like that. Right? So now 10 plus 1 is 11. So again you can 10 multiply 11 divide from 2. Now you know that 10 is 10 multiply 11. You want 10 multiply from 11 is 110 divide from 2. Now you have an answer now 55. Like that. So 55 means you know the triangle pattern number. Triangle pattern 10th term is 55. This is term and term plus 1 divide from 2. And now you look observe clearly that triangular pattern 10th term is 55. The triangular pattern. Now what is the answer? Triangular number pattern. Right? Triangular number pattern. Like this. Triangular number pattern. This is the example. This 10, 10 plus 1, 10, 11, 100, 10, 55. That is the example. Now the correct one is triangular number pattern. Now the general term. The general term is this. Term plus 1 divide 2 is the general term of this triangular pattern. Now that is the general term. And they are given a 10th term. Find the 10th term of this general term. N1, 2. And you want to firstly like this 10 get. And you want to continue this. And you have answer now. Like that. So that is the triangular number pattern. General term is this. So this is why 8, 9 and 10 questions in this paper. Okay, great day guys. Let's move to the next question of this paper, part 1. This is your 11th and 12th question in this paper, great day guys. Let's move to the 11th question. Fill in the blanks. Now you have plus 3. Multiply blank multiply 0 means what? Minus 3 multiply 0. And what is the answer? Blank. And you want to fill in the blanks. Now let's check the answers. Now the plus 3 multiply sum 1 multiply 0 means minus 3. Now you want to get the answer for that these two multiply and get the answer this. Now the plus 3 is something multiply and you have the what minus 3, that is a minus 1. Correct? That is a minus 1. If you get this plus 3 multiply sum 1, answer is minus 3, so this also minus. You get the number like this. You want to get the number line. You should get a number line. And what? You go class 3. This is class 3. Right? This is minus 3. Now you have a minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Now they have 6. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Now you have 6. Now connect to this point and you have a 6. You want to firstly get the characteristics from class 3. You get plus 2, plus 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. Now, what is the answer? Minus 6. Right? Now, plus 3 multiply minus 6 means minus 3. Nextly, they have multiplied from 0. Right? They are multiplied from 0. The something multiplied, the someone or the some number multiplied from 0 means 0. Now 2 multiplied 0 is 0. 1 multiplied 0 is 0. 3 multiplied 0 is 0. 1000 multiplied from 0, 0. 1000 multiplied from 0, 0. So, any number that 1 right from 0 means 0. So, that is the 11th one. 11th question. You want to keep the mind, whole number multiplied from 0, answer is 0. 12th one, write the perimeter of this figure. They have no centimeters. Or they have no identify the V. Find a perimeter. You have a 10, 10, 10, 8 like that. So this figure, they are no have digits. Right? Now, how can we find this? How can we find this? You want to get algebraic expressions, right? Now you have these two opposites, right? Now you can get 2x and these two opposites, 2y. These two opposites again 2x. If they have no digits, you can get the algebraic expressions. Xx, yy, xx like that. Now the 2x plus 2y plus 2x. Now guys, classify this. Now, 2x plus 2x means 7. Now the 2x plus 2x plus 4x means 4x. Right? 4x plus this 2y. Right? So this is the answer for that perimeter. Again explain, they have no digits that identify to find the perimeter. Now you want to these algebraic expressions connect with or separate like this. These two 2x, these two 2y, these two 2x. Now 2x plus 2x means 4x and remain 2y. 4x plus 2y is the answer. Let's see who to the next questions in this. This is your next 3 questions in your paper. Now 13 questions ready guys. Write down the suitable units to measure the following masses. Now you have the medicine, a loaded truck. You know the medicine means the smaller one. Smaller one. Now this is a medicine, right? Is that pressure from grams?
No.
Milligrams. Milligrams. The Panadol tablet means 500 milligrams. Piritan 750 milligrams. Like that. Medicines. Medicines measure in milligrams. Now the next part, a loaded truck. You know the truck means a big one. Now loaded, you can measure in kilos, but they have a suitable method, but metric ton or ton. Right? Metric ton or ton, and the loaded truck, you can get the suitable unit is metric ton or ton. In the 14th one, express this A3 multiply 2B3 multiply C3. A to the power 3, 2B to the power 3, C to the power 3. Now, A to the power 3 means they have 3 A's. So, you can A multiply. I can A multiply A multiply A. Right? And now they have 2B to the power 3. Now they have 3 2Bs. So you can write 2B multiply 2B multiply 2B. Right? And they are C also. They have 3 C's. So you can write C multiply C multiply C. Now this is the indices you express this. You have A to the power 3 like this, 2B to the power 3 like this, C to the power 3 like this. And the 15th one, 5, 4 to the power 2 multiply 5 to the power 2 in a square 1, square root. Now, you know that 4 to the power 2 is 16. 5 to the power 2 is 25. Now, this is 4. Now, you want to divide this from 4. Right? And this is 5. So, you want to divide from this in from 5. Right? Now, they are common. They have common one. This is 4. And their common one is 5. Right? Now you can get this as 4 multiply 5. So this values common one is 4, this values common one is 5. So you can get this 4 multiply 5. Now what is the 4 multiply 5? 20. 20 is the answer. So this is the 13, 14 and 15 question. Okay guys, let's move to the next questions in this paper. This is your last 5 questions in this paper. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 16, 1, right, true or false? Now you have a algebraic expressions or singular name mean Vijaya Prakashana. Now first one, 4pq subtract 12pqr equal 4pq brackets 1 subtract 3r. Is it correct? 4pq, you know we want to multiply this, right? Now 4pq multiply 1 is 4pq, correct. Subtract 4pq, multiply 3r, 12pqr, correct. Now you can get a tick mark. And the second one, minus 3, in the brackets 2x plus 3 equals 6x, subtract 9. That is wrong. I give the method. There might Why that is wrong? Minus 3 multiplied from 2x means what? Minus 6x. And minus 3 multiplied 3 means minus 9. Is they all minus? Is they all minus? No. Is they are minus? Correct. This is minus 1 they are. So that is the one that get the false one for the second part. In the 17th question, grade 8, guys, the area of square is 256 meters square. Find length of a side. The area of square is 256. The square, they have four sides. Right? Now the 256 divide from side. The area divide from sides. Now, the 25, suppose they have 6. Now 25 remain 1 and 6. The 16 to 4, 4. Now you look, observe really the 64 they have. So you want 64 right in here. You can write 64 meters, right? In the 18th question, find the 7 ton 200 kg, 1 take 700 kg, subtract all. There are 200, we can't subtract from 700, so you want to get a ton. So there. And now they have 1200 kilograms. Subtract from 700. Answer is 500 kilograms. Now remain 6 tons. 6 tons subtract from 1 ton means 500 kilograms. Right? You want to first see the ton given for there. And now they have 1001. Now 1200 kg subtract 700 kg is 500 kg. Now there remain 6 ton. 6 ton subtract 1 ton means 5 ton. And 17th question also again explained this. 64 is the side, the one side. 64. Now you can write 64 into 2. 19th one, find the negative 1 to the power 3 multiply 3 to the power 2. I think that is difficult. Right? I think that means that is difficult. Right? How can I get the answer? You know the minus or the that a whole number is negative or a whole number is odd number. Now this also odd number, so that is negative. And this one is plus and this one is also even number, so that is positive. So you can get this as negative 1. And 3 to the power 2 means 3 multiplied 3. 9. Now, the negative 1 multiplied from 9 means that biggest one is what? This minus 1. Now, what is the answer? This is the answer. Minus 9 is the answer. So, the minus 1 is biggest in this. Now, minus 9 is the answer. That is the 19th question, this paper. So grade 8 guys, this is your last question. Last question in this paper, part 1. Is x is 2 and y is 3, find x plus 3y. Then firstly, get the x value is 2 plus 3 and y's power is 3. Now you want to multiply from 3. And you have answer 2 multiply. 3 multiply 3 is 9. 2 multiply 3. Then 2 plus minus 11. So that is the answer for that. Again. Now they again explaining. X is 2 plus 3 is 3. Y is 3. You want to multiply from that. Right? 3 multiply from that value. And you have answer 2 plus 9 is 11. 2 plus 9 is 11. So this is your last 5 questions. This is the last question. So I think now you can clear this paper. Western Province Question 2018, Grade 8, Part 1. Next video, Math Games. Have a nice day. Bye. Bye, guys.